Hi everyone, my name is Kate, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily use Azure SDKs to interact with Azure services directly from your applications. As you may know, Azure has dozens of services that you can use to improve the capabilities of your application, from things like storing information to adding some additional intelligence with pre-built ML models. In this demo, I'm going to use Azure Text Analytics service to apply sentiment analysis to the tweets I collected from Twitter about Python. So what I'm going to do is to navigate to my browser and go to aka.ms/azsdk/python. Here I'm going to find a list of all of the Python packages that we have on Azure that follow the same set of guidelines that make them easier to use, and also easier to use together. So if you're using a couple of different Azure services, all of these packages should work together pretty well. I pulled up some information for you for what are some common features that you can find in these. The first thing is authentication. So we wanted to make the experience of authenticating to your service both secure and easy. So you'll find a library called Azure Identity that works with all of these libraries that enables you to authenticate more easily. We'll go into a bit deeper into that in a bit. The next thing is retries, which is really crucial for cloud application development. Additional policy that we have is about logging, which should make debugging easier for you so that you can see what is happening in your application. The last item I wanted to highlight is distributed tracing. So if you're using a couple of different services, you can see how your request is traveling between them. If you want to learn more about all of these policies, I recommend going to aka.ms/azsdk/blog, where you're going to find some blog posts on how to actually use them. For now, what I'm interested in is just getting the library to begin with. So I'm going to go to docs for text analytics, and here I'll find the right pip install for the text analytics library. At this point, let me switch over to my VS Code, and here in my terminal, I'm going to install the most recent version of text analytics. I already have it, but I just wanted to show you how that could look like. Another package I'm going to get is Azure Identity. As I mentioned, this is the library that we use for authentication, so it definitely should be helpful here. Okay, awesome. Once I got my library in place, one more thing I need to do is to actually set up the resource in Azure by navigating to my browser. I can go to create a resource and basically search for text analytics and create. Here, I just need to provide it some cool name, choose the subscription I want to use, the location that works best for me. And there's also a free tier that you can use to actually interact with text analytics. Once you have that set up, you're going to be taken to a quick start tab where you're going to find all of the information you need and some documentation on how to get started. From here, the only thing I need is the endpoint. So going back to my VS Code, you'll see that the endpoint I'm using is actually here in my client. So let's take a look to actually see what is happening within my application. The first thing I do is to get the tweets from Twitter, which is accessing Twitter API. Then I'm going to analyze the sentiment by using the text analytics client. The main way in which you're going to start your setup is by getting the client for the service you're using. You can see that from the text analytics package, I'm using the text analytics client. And what I need to provide it is the endpoint that we've just gotten from the portal, and then the credential. Here is where we're actually using the Azure Identity library, which has the default Azure credential. This is really the authentication credential you probably want to use most of the time. The way it works is that it actually has a couple of different authentication methods roll underneath it so that it picks the best one for the occasion. You can set up your environment variables as the first authentication method, which is what I'm using here. The second authentication method it tries is managed identity, which works for when your application is released into production on Azure. The last thing that should be the most helpful is by a single sign-on that works with a number of developer tools. We're still working on expanding the range of the tools it works with, but you can imagine that eventually you should be just able to log in via the editor you're using or some CLI tools. And after you just log in, the library should work out of the box. Once you have your client set up, that is going to be your entry point for all of the operations. So I use my text analytics client and I use the analyze sentiment method on my tweets. Now for each tweet that we have gotten back, for each tweet that was assessed as positive, I increase my total score. If the tweet was negative, I deduct the score from the point. And then I calculate the average of the overall score. So now let's see what happens when I run it. Yeah, keep this Python spirit up. So good stuff. If you want to try it out yourself, go to aka.ms/azsdk/python, and you'll find that list that I've been using of all of the libraries that follow these new patterns. There, you'll also find links to our GitHub, where you can provide us feedback at any time. We look through the issues every day, so if you have any thoughts on how your experience has gone, feel free to create an issue there. Other than that, good luck and thanks for watching the video.